Welcome to our synod-wide service this first Sunday of Christmas. I say of Christmas instead of after Christmas because, of course, for us in the church, it's a 12-day celebration. You know the song. Where did I put those three French hymns? In any case, we celebrate today with a festival of lessons and carols, which originated a little more than 100 years ago in Christmas Eve 1918 at King's College in England. That service always began with the English tune, Once in Royal David's City, and includes lessons that spans salvation history. Your Christmas Eve and mine, your Christmas Day, were no doubt different this pandemic year than anything you can imagine, giving this baby's birth all the more power and relevance for us. This baby, Jesus the Christ, changed and is changing everything. Our first reading today recounts our age-old struggle with sin as we continue to drift away from our intended relationships with God and with each other. God comes to us in the prophecy of Isaiah for the stage setting for God's dramatic intervention. Becoming one of us, born of Mary, wherever you are right now, sing along. And may the beautiful music and these time-honored readings be a blessing to you as we prepare our hearts and minds to continue in the hope and the joy, even now, of Christmas.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who was in the beginning, who makes a dwelling among us, who covers us with justice and mercy. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. God, God of goodness and loving kindness. We confess that we have sinned against you and our neighbors. We have turned away from your invitation to new life. We have turned away from the lowly and downtrodden. In your abundant mercy, forgive us our sins, those we know and those known only to you, for the sake of the one who came to live among us, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Hear the good news of peace and salvation. God forgives us all our sins, not through our own work, but through Jesus Christ, made known to all people. With all who come to the manger, rejoice in this amazing gift of grace. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, you wonderfully created the dignity of human nature, and yet more wonderfully restored it. In your mercy, let us share the divine life of the one who came to share our humanity, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first lesson is from the third chapter of Genesis, beginning with the 8th verse. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and the man and his wife had hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." He drove out the man, and at the east of the Garden of Eden, he placed the cherubim and a sword flaming and turning to guard the way to the tree of life. Here ends the reading.
Thank you. A reading from Isaiah. Those who have lived in a land of deep darkness, in them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. Oh, come thou day spring, come and cheer our spirits by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night and death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou key of David, come and open wide our heavenly home. Make safe the way that leads on high, and close the path of misery. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
The third lesson from Luke chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy, and he will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word. And then the angel departed from her.
Breaking the silence into the chaos you came. Born in our likeness, held in the hands that you made. For our deliverance, the promise was given a name. Emmanuel. Was born on that day. Christmas was born on that day. As it is written, Jesus, the glory of God. Reputation, you took on our flesh and our blood. Yes, you did. For our forgiveness and for the world that you love. Emmanuel, the God who saves. I hear a voice. Heaven declare, prepare the way. Emmanuel, oh, praise his name. I hear the sound, heaven crying out, love made way. Christmas was born, your king. Come, glory to God with us. Angels adore, bow down before. Glory to God with us. Christmas was born, your kingdom come. Glory to God with us. Angels adore, bow down before. Glory to God with us. Emmanuel, the God who saves. I hear a voice from heaven declare, prepare the way. Emmanuel, oh pray. I hear the sound, heaven crying out, and love made way. Christmas was born on that day. Christmas was born on that day. Never be the same. Christmas was born on that day. Hey. sides, into the chaos you came.
Fourth lesson comes from the second chapter of Luke, beginning with the first verse. Luke writes, "In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Gospel of Luke. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world and sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn.
Sixth lesson. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Thank you. And now the prayers of intercession. Joining our voices with the song of the angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Night and day, all creation praises you, O God. Strengthen your church across nations, denominations, and traditions. Fill us with wisdom and unify our proclamation of your forgiveness and mercy. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. All creation is holy to you, O God. You cause the earth to bring forth its shoots and gardens to spring up. Protect hibernating animals in frozen lands that wait earnestly for longer days of awakening and growth. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. The nations are upheld by your hand, O God. Cause righteousness and praise to spring forth, inspiring leaders to serve with compassion and integrity. Send your spirit of discernment upon legislators grappling with complex decisions for the sake of the common good. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Send the spirit of your Son into our hearts, O God. Come quickly to hearts that race with fear, hearts that break with grief, and hearts that long for wholeness, especially those we name aloud or silently on our hearts. Reveal your power to heal and to save. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Adopt us into your family, O God. Bless our elders with the peace and joy of Simeon and Anna. Strengthen those who have retired, those who work in older age, and those in need of income, food, company, or health care. Connect young and old across generations. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Now I invite you to offer your own prayer petitions at this time, either silently or aloud. In the midst of the chaos, Lord, we call upon you. You know the fires that burn, the hurricanes that rage, the divisiveness that divides us, the prejudices, the racism, the call of using language against our siblings that we ought not do. Help us, Lord, to lean into your reconciliation and your healing power, drawing us to be unified for the sake of the gospel. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Let us depart in peace, O God, according to your word. For all your saints, we give you thanks. Prepare our salvation in the sight of all your witnesses of every time and place. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The eighth lesson from the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being, in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness. The darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of our Lord. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God.
In the beginning was the same as the Word was with God, and the same was
the word of God.
Almighty God, who sent the Holy Spirit to Mary, proclaimed joy through the angels, sent the shepherds to share good news, and led the Magi by a star, bless you this day and always through the Word made flesh. Amen.
Salvation that blessed Christmas morn.